So, today's topic is hyperplane arrangements. That's a geometric application of the theory of Weber's function, which we developed on previous para. What is the arrangement? We consider the affine space finite dimensional k to the n, where k is a field. And we consider hyperplanes as a set defined by a affine equation. The alpha 1 and so on, alpha n are not all zero without zero. Okay. And the hyperplane arrangement is just some certain set of hyperplanes. Set of hyperplanes. Like some set of lines on the plane. So these two lines are parallel and so something like that. Several definitions about this object. We say that hyperplane arrangement is central if all hyperplanes have a common point. In this case, they may be translated so that your hyperplanes become linear. So you have zero here. With any hyperplane, we have a corresponding lattice. Let us call the arrangement calligraphic A, and L of A is a lattice of intersections. So the elements are sets of the form intersection of H, where H goes through some subset of A. H belongs to B, where B is a some subset of A. So, say on this picture, the elements of your lattice are the empty intersection is the whole space. Elements are non-empty intersections. So we consider only those sets which are non-empty. Intersection over the fine empty set is the whole space by definition. It is a empty intersection, means no restriction, so any point satisfies them, just such view, quite natural. Well, so here we have one intersection, which is a plane, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 intersections which are lines, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 intersections which are points. And these are the elements, and they're ordered with respect to reverse inclusion. So we say that X is greater than Y, it means that XX is a subset of Y, yes, such way, reverse. So the full Kn is the minimal element. Kn is a zero in L of A. Okay, and we see that this is a geometric lattice. Oops. Recall that it was defined as this way by geometric. It means that any point is a join of atoms. Atoms are our hyperplanes. Any point is joined just by definition. Okay. Well. Also, let us define the rank of arrangement. Rank of arrangement. It is the dimension of the linear span of normals to hyperplanes. So normals are this vector alpha 1, alpha n. It is in general defined up to scalar, but if we count the dimension of span, it doesn't matter, of course. It is, of course, at most n. And when it equals n, we say that it is full rank arrangement. And if it less than n, then essentially this is a dimension of in a smaller space, right? For example, if you have several parallel lines on the plane, you see that essentially this is one-dimensional arrangement. You may take a line which is not parallel to them all, and consider what these hyperplanes form on this line. Uh, Okay, and this is called the essentialization of arrangement. It is denoted as essentialization of A. It is strictly defined as follows. You should consider intersection of all planes with a plane to which they are all orthogonal in the sense of this bilinear form. Right? Or no, not orthogonal in the... It works over real numbers, but in general, the vector may be orthogonal to itself, and such definition doesn't work. You should consider the vectors which are orthogonal to all normals if your arrangement is not full rank, then there exist such vectors, non-zero, which are orthogonal to all normals. And this should be the complement to this space. Say in coordinates, if all normals have zero coordinate with respect to n's, so if arrangement is not full rank, then without Ossoff generality, all normals have zero coordinate here. Then you just forget about n's coordinate. Okay, well, that's a clear thing. Great. Then we want to calculate several things. If the arrangement is real, so your field is real, you may define the domains onto which they divide the space. And the number of domains is not domains, but the region. The number of regions is denoted R of A. So regions are the open components of the set Rn without all these hyperplanes. So you remove all these planes, your space becomes divided onto open components, which are convex, of course. And the number of such components is denoted R of A. Also, some components are essentially bounded. Essentially means that they are bounded in essentialization. For example, in this picture, these two strips are essentially bounded because they become intervals in essentialization, while these two hyperplanes are not essentially bounded. And the number of essentially bounded components is denoted B of A. Many interesting problems reduced to the enumeration of these objects, and in order to deal with them, we use the Möbius function of this lattice, as I am going to show. Let's see. We consider the following polynomial one variable x is the sum of all elements of your intersection lattice. Mu of 0 t times x to dim of t. Here dimension is linear algebraic dimension. If your arrangement is essential, then dimension of t equals n minus rank of t, where this is a rank in lattice. Rank in the lattice. For example, the zero in your lattice is the whole Kn, and so on. It has dimension n and rank zero. Okay. It has rank equal to n only if your dimension is essential. So that you may get a single point as an intersection. Okay. Well, and we study this. Let's write here zero with hat, because actually as a subspace it is not zero, but on the contrary Kn. Okay. We know that the coefficients of these polynomials interchange in sign, that what we proved for semi-modular lattices, right, on previous para. Note that the coefficient of x to n minus 1 in this, it is called characteristic polynomial. Characteristic polynomial. Here a of x equals to what? I think it equals to minus the number of arrangements. Yes, because n minus 1 appears only for atoms. For atoms this is minus 1 always, because the interval is a possible two elements. And well, so we get this formula. Okay, and so we see that the coefficients change their signs. The coefficient of x to the n is of course 1. Well, great. Our main result in which we use the theory developed earlier is the following formula. For the this polynomial, the theorem here a of x equals the sum of subarrangements. Sum arrangement is defined by some subset of A. Any subset of your arrangement is a subarrangement, which are central, so they have non-empty intersection, minus 1 to the number of elements, the number of planes in B, times x to n minus 1 B. Oops. Well, that's the formula. Well, let's prove it. Actually, we almost did it. We just want to understand what happens. I recall which formula was proved. We know that Möbius function of 0t in a lattice is a sum over k minus 1 to k nk of t, where nk of t is the number of k subsets with join equal to t. It is the cross-cut theorem. Right, which we studied a week ago. One moment. Right. Well, that was the Philip Hoch theorem. This was, one moment. This was Weissner's theorem, and this was Kraskat theorem with join equal to t. Yes, I think cross-cut was was a dual statement when we considered subsets with mid equal to 1. It was for, in cross-cut theorem we had Möbius of 0 and 1, but we may restrict on the interval between 0 and t. And also dualize. Okay. We have such formula, and now let us see what does it mean that the join equals to t. In our lattice, the join is just the intersection, right? So the join of several affine subspaces, which are elements of our lattice, is the intersection. Okay, then we may write that, proceed this formula, that the explanation, this is the sum for over all subsets of here we should consider only the sets which contain C, yes, otherwise the intersection will not be equal to t. Denote this subset of A, this subspaces contain, which contain c. Subspaces which contain c And such that the intersection equals to T minus 1 to the number of elements of B, right? I alternatively use sharp and cardinality and vertical as absolute value. Well, let us see. Do we already get what we need? Minus 1 to number elements of V, because this is K for this is sum over subsets. Well, I think it is okay. Well, now we should, I think, multiply it by x to dimension of t. This is formula for Möbius function, yes. Then we multiply it by x to dimension of t. X to dimension of t. Great. And sum up over all t. Here, when we sum up over all t, we get the heuristic polynomial by definition. And here we will get z because any b will be calculated only once because it has only one intersection, which is t. And then dimension will be equal to n minus rank of b. Yes, because for central it is some obvious linear algebra. If you have a central arrangement, so several subspaces which share a common point, then the dimension of the intersection of these guys equals to n minus the rank. Yes, if you have several hyperplanes, then dimension of the intersection is n minus the dimension n minus rank, where rank is the span of dimension of the span of normals. Okay. Well, so that's it, and we proved this theorem. This theorem sometimes is useful itself, but maybe more important, it gives us a very nice and not trivial recursion. Okay, let me write down this recursion. That's the definition of arrangement I remove. Recursion is the following. Consider a real arrangement A. Choose a hyperplane in this arrangement H0. Then we consider two other arrangements. One of them is sub-arrangement. It is called A prime. It is just obtained from A by removing this hyperplane. Set difference if you want. We remove this hyperplane and consider all others. This is sub-arrangement. And A 2 prime is arrangement in H0 induced by other hyperplanes. So it is arrangement in different space in H0 induced by H intersected H0, where H in A without H0, A by omega. For example, on this picture, we may choose H0 to be, say, this line, then if it is non-empty, H not only doesn't equal to zero, but also H is not parallel to H0. So here we will get A2 prime. Well, A prime is just obtained by removing H0. It's not difficult to draw it, right? This is A prime. And this is A2 prime. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and if there were other line to this point, there will be still one point in A2 prime. So we ignore the multiplicities. So it is just a set of such intersections, not a multiset, because several different H may give the same in H0, but we don't care. Okay, it is two smaller arrangements. They are smaller, for example, in the sense of number of hyperplanes. It is strictly smaller than in A for both. Well, and what is the recursion? It is the following beautiful formula. That here A of X equals here A prime of X minus here A2 prime of X. Okay, let us prove this formula. We use this theorem because we It is hard to deal with Möbius function directly, so we and this definition doesn't contain Möbius function, so we use it. Before we prove several words, it is not clear at all that there is a polynomial satisfying such recursion. That because you may remove one hyperplane, you may remove another hyperplane, and if you just try to define axiomatically polynomial satisfying such recursion, it is not obvious at all why you don't get a contradiction. So you don't get to a different formula for characteristic polynomial of the same arrangement with removing different H zeros. That this definition is correct is actually what is the theorem about. Okay, so let's prove it. It is not different, difficult. Here we may consider two sub-sums. For B containing H0 and B not containing H0. If we consider B not containing H0, I guess you get this expression, right? It is less or more clear by definition, because A prime is just obtained by removing H0. And the rank, it depends only on set B. So you here just consider the sum of all B in A prime. Great. So we need to prove that what we get if we include H0 is this expression. Let's see. Here we have each what I said, that we ignore the multiplicities, that several hyperplanes may have the same intersection with H0. And assume that we have S hyperplanes in A satisfying the formula H intersected H0 equals, I don't know, alpha. So alpha is a hyperplane is in H0, and we have many elements in A which intersect with H0 by the same alpha. But I claim that if we remain only one of them, then this sum over subsets containing H0 doesn't change. Indeed. If we have several subsets containing alpha, then if you look at this sum, it is the same as we have one subset containing alpha. Let us see. For example, we have I wanted to describe bijection, but maybe it is easier to write the formula. The idea is that we have many summons here because we have S hyperplanes with the same intersection. But all of them except those say all by one cancel. How to explain it? Well, let us denote these hyperplanes H1, H2, and so on, HS. Yes. We may get one of them. It may be done by S ways to choose one of them. We have S choose two ways to choose two of them. We have S choose three ways to choose three of them, and so on. And here it contributes to S minus S choose two plus S choose three minus so on. It is exactly one. Yes? Yes, it is. Because alternating sum of binomials is zero. Okay? It doesn't depend on S, this contribution. That's why we may remain only one hyperplane for each intersection. For fixed alpha, we may remain only one of them and the sum doesn't change. And if we remain one, then this sum is just minus this, minus because here is n and dimension of H0 is n minus one. So that's the proof of the theorem. If it recalls you the recursion for that polynomial of Matroid, it is not just a coincidence. I defined regions and bounded regions but didn't connect them to these polynomials. This may be done using the following lemma. In the same notations, if we have selected hyperplane H0, two partitions A prime and A2 prime, arrangements, sorry, then we have A of A equals A of A prime plus A of A2 prime, and B of A equals to B of A pi plus B of A2 pi if rank of A pi equals to rank of A. And zero otherwise. Otherwise, it means that rank of A pi is rank of A minus one. Okay, let's see. Let's start with this. The idea is very simple. You remove H0, you have as many regions. After that, you add H0. How many new regions you have? The answer so many. It's because any new region which is added corresponds to a region in H0 itself, right? Okay, and for this, at first let us see that why BFA is zero otherwise. That's because if, or better to say, if BFA is non-zero, then we have this equality. That's the same statement. Assume that B of A is non-zero, so there is a bounded region. But if we have the bounded region, then of course the normals to corresponding hyperplanes span the whole space. They cannot be orthogonal to something. And also, moreover, they are linearly dependent, and all of them except one still span the whole space. Yeah, because say if all of them are parallel to a vertical line, so that we have several planes in the three-dimensional space which are all vertical, they form such a strip. And by one hyperplane, you cannot form a bounded thing from it, right? The other proof is that they are dependent with coefficients equal to areas of this convex polytope formed by these hyperplanes. And from this, from this relation, we see that all of them but one still generate the whole space. Therefore, if you remove any hyperplane, then either all these planes remain or all but one of them remain, and they still have full rank. Therefore, rank of A prime surely equals to rank of A if there is at least one bounded region. Okay, so that we proved, and next, if there was a bounded region, that bounded region in remove H0, we had some bounded regions, and after that we remove H0. And what happens? If it intersected a bounded region, it increases both this and this. And if it intersects a non-bounded region, but by region bounded in H0, like that, that it intersects again this and this by one. Yes, we add one bounded region here and one bounded region here. Well, and it could intersect unbounded region by unbounded, then nothing increases. So in any case, this, we see that the difference between this and this equals this. Well, that's similar to this recursion, yes? And it allows us to get the following nice formula. That the number of regions equals minus one to the n characteristic polynomial in minus one. That's one theorem, and another is that the number of bounded regions equals minus one to rank of A times characteristic polynomial at one. Well, when formulated, you see that this should be provable by induction, and indeed it is the case. Only why you have different things here, also very similar here, because you should have something with base of your induction. The base of induction is empty arrangement. Well, let it be empty arrangement. Then we have one region, and this guy is x to the n. You have only one summon here. This L of A consists only of one element. And this is one, this is also one. Very good. After that, use induction. If you remove a hyperplane, then the right-hand side here is a sum of this expression for A pi and A 2 pi. The sum not difference because you have minus 1 to the n, and n here and here differ by 1. Okay, that's the proof of the first equality by induction. And so both parts satisfy this recursion and the initial value. For B of A, we should let us see. B of empty set is one because this region is relatively bounded. It is non-trivial because there's one region which is the whole space that looks unbounded. But actually, relatively, it is bounded because relatively, this whole space is just one point. Okay? Essentialization is one point is bounded. Great. So B of empty set is one. And here, rank of empty is zero. And here, empty of one is one, so both parts are equal to one. After that, you should check that right-hand side of this expression satisfies this recurrence, right? Let us see. So we want to prove that this expression satisfies this recurrence. Okay. So let us substitute this. Well, let us write it. So we want to prove that minus 1 to rank of A, here A of 1, equals to minus 1 to rank of A pi, here A pi of 1 plus minus 1 to rank of A 2 pi times here A 2 pi of 1 let us call this case 1 and 0 in case 2 is otherwise. Let us see. Consider the case one. When removing your hyperplane doesn't change the rank. Then here a of one equals this difference. And rank of a prime equals to rank of n, and rank of a two prime equals to rank of a minus one, I guess, because if you remove, consider all that intersects with H0, when H0 isn't special hyperplane, so it decreases the rank, then the rank is less by one. I think it is, well, if it was a full rank and you remove the plane which does not, well, it is easier to understand if you think than if you listen. When, well, if что-то стрёмно теперь. Это окей. If you have h zero and you had a full rank arrangement, and it is full rank even if you remove H0, then it is full rank if you intersect it with H0. Say, for example, if H0 is a hyperplane in which n's coordinate is zero, and you, what you do, you consider the, say, matrix of your normals. Say, you write your normal as a row. Say, this is one normal, this is another normal, and so on. And it has, it is full rank matrix. You remove the last column, it remains a full rank matrix because the rank cannot be increased more than by one if you remove one column, yes? Okay, well, it is something obvious. So you get this relation, yes, because ranks differ by one and here you had minus. In the second case, here the rank both time decreased by one, and you so have zero if you substitute here a of one to this relation. So well, let me say, assume that removing H0 decreases the rank. It means that say your place was say horizontal and all other places were vertical. Then these two arrangements are isomorphic, so you may consider the full arrangement A prime, or you may intersect it with H0, you get isomorphic arrangements. Since they are isomorphic, you get that here A of 1 by this formula is 0. Okay. So in all cases, it satisfies the same relation, and we get such a nice formula for B of A. Let us, for example, consider the most simple case of the general position arrangement. So imagine that you take general position M planes in general position in Rn. In general position, it means that any n of them have unique common point, and no n plus 1 have a common point. So, say, it happens with probability 1 if you take the planes at random with respect to some natural, say, continuous measure on the set of planes. Then I claim that here A of X equals x to the n minus m x to n minus 1 plus m choose 2 x to n minus 2 minus so on. And so R of A equals 1 plus m plus m choose 2 plus m choose n. And B of A equals more nice expression. It is 1, here I substituted minus 1, yes. So all signs were plus. Now I substitute 1, and I get 1. I get minus 1 to the n times such expression, 1 minus m plus m choose 2, and so on. It surprisingly equals to m minus 1 choose n. So in this case, this sum may be reduced to a single binomial coefficient. Okay, let's see why we know that so. This formula follows from the formula with central subsets. Yes, any k planes form where k is at most m, form a central rearrangement of rank n minus k of dimensional n minus k. So you get this formula just by this expression for here A and the fact that they are in general position. Okay, then we substitute minus 1 here, we get Z. Next we substitute 1 here, we get Z, and this formula is I think it follows by induction, or so you fix with here you have minus 1 n to m choose n, right? So you get, if you multiply and change the order, you have such formula m times n minus m times n minus 1 plus m choose n minus 2 minus m choose n minus 3 plus so on. It equals m minus 1 choose n. For example, you may replace each binomial via Pascal triangle equality. M choose k equals m minus 1 choose k plus m minus 1 choose k minus 1. And you see that anything except z cancels out. Yes. Because it is ones with plus and ones with minus in consecutive items here. Okay. So the number of bounded regions is such a nice expression, and the number of all regions not so nice. But that's what it is. Okay, now we consider more interesting arrangements. The one interesting arrangement is the so-called braid arrangement. It is defined by hyperplanes xi minus xj equals 0 over all pairs of I and j. So it has how much n, n factorial, I think, regions, because the region corresponds to the order of axes. In each region, the order in which axes are, which of them is greater, is fixed. Because the half spaces for such hyperplanes correspond to which of two variables is greater. Okay. And what is the what is the lattice of this partition? Let us see. What is the intersection of several such partitions? So we may visualize these hyperplanes as edges of complete graph, and imagine that we choose some edges. What is the intersection of corresponding hyperplanes? It means that these variables are equal, these variables are equal, these variables are equal. Yeah, so it depends only on connected components of this graph. And so they are in one-to-one correspondence with partitions of the set. Yeah, so we see that intersection of these hyperplanes, they differ, is the corresponding partitions differ. And one of them is contained in another if one partition is a sub-partition of another. So we get the lattice of partitions. Of n set, set with n elements. So the corresponding characteristic polynomial relies on Möbius function of this lattice. Well, and what I claim is that he it's called Bn from the word braid. Here Bn of x equals to x times x minus 1 times x minus n plus 1. Well, that has to be proved. I explain how to prove it later, but now I consider yet another interesting partition. This is called what we may remain here. I think this is partial case, it may be removed. It is a so-called Shea arrangement. It is defined by the such hyperplanes, the same as in braid arrangement, and also shifted for E less than G. So we have twice more hyperplanes. And now it is not so much obvious how much regions are there, yes? There were n factorial for braid arrangement. It was less or more obvious because they corresponded to permutations. Now they correspond to something different. Yes, of course, to permutation, and that second, the difference 1. So we should fix which variables are at distance at least 1. It is in one-to-one correspondence with, well, now I'll say the answer and you will see, will guess with what it is in one-to-one correspondence, and it is not obvious. That let us denote it as n in honor of Xi, and the formula is the following. Here's n of x equals to x times x minus 1 to n minus 1. So for the number of regions, we get regions of Sn equals to minus 1 to n times minus 1 times minus n minus 1 to n minus 1. It is 1 plus 1 to n minus 1. You of course know this number. It is the number of labeled trees on n plus 1 vertices, which also correspond to parking functions and many other things. And them are bijections with trees, but we don't discuss them, at least now, maybe on seminars. And for bounded regions, we get the formula n minus 1 to n minus 1. Which also corresponds to some kind of label trees or so on. This is B. Okay, but how do you prove such formulas? There is a beautiful method which is the following. Instead of considering real arrangement, we consider this arrangement over finite field with the same planes. Over finite field FP, where P is a large prime. Note that the corresponding lattices are isomorphic for if you consider these planes over reals and modular large prime. Why so? Because the rank of any intersection, it corresponds to rank of matrices, and it corresponds to the where the determinants are zero. If determinants for fixed n, all determinants are uniformly bounded, and they are zero or non-zero in reals and modulo p simultaneously, if p is large enough. So you take p which is greater than all subdeterminants, how do you call them, minors of all matrices which are true, and then the property that some system of linear equations have dimensions of the solutions are the same in reals and modulo p. So the lattices are isomorphic. And so these polynomials are isomorphic, are the same simply. Okay. But for Q, you may calculate the characteristic polynomial that we consider over FQ. Then we know that here A of Q equals to cardinality of the whole space FQ to the n minus the union of all hyperplanes of these hyperplanes. So what is written here, that the value at Q itself is the number of points not covered by your hyperplanes. Over reals, it doesn't make sense because infinitely many points are not covered. But over Q, it is a number, you may calculate it. Okay, let us prove this formula. It is just a Möbius inversion. Let me write it down. The proof of this nice formula. You consider two functions when t is belong to this lattice. Now A is over FQ, so the set of hyperplanes H and A over FQ. And for element of this lattice, we denote two functions. F of t equals the number of elements in T. T is a subspace, so it is some power of Q, of always. This is one function, and another function, G of T, is a number of elements not covered by the union of all greater elements. Greater, it means a smaller intersection. So G of T is a number of elements which belong to T but don't belong to smaller intersection. Now smaller in the sense of size, but larger in our posit. That's why I write greater here. Okay, so we have two such functions. Then obviously we have f of t equals to sum over u at least t g of t. Because any element in t, it is belongs to sum of this set for some u. So for any point, we have the minimal intersection containing this point. And we sum up by fixing this g of u, sorry, by fixing this minimal intersection. Then by Möbius inversion, we get g of t equals to sum of u at least t mu of tu f of u, right? And f of t, it is of course q to dimension of t. We may write here q to dimension of u. And for g equal to zero, it means that the number of elements not covered by all hyperplanes, we get g of zero equals the sum of over all u, because all u are at least zero, mu of zero, zero in our lattice, zero u, u to dimension of u. It is by definition the characteristic polynomial at Q. Great. Okay, so this formula is essentially Möbius inversion for these two functions. Very good. So we reduce the calculation of polynomial at prime numbers or prime powers, if you wish, by counting the number of points. And for example, for braid rearrangement, it is very easy to calculate. Because what does it mean? That the point doesn't lie in all these hyperplanes. It means that all its coordinates are different, right? And of course, the number of points with different coordinates is q times q minus 1 times q minus n plus 1, right? We have as many points with different coordinates. The first q ways to choose the first coordinate, q minus 1 ways to choose the second coordinate, and so on. So we get this. And because the polynomial is defined by its values at large prime numbers, because there are infinitely many primes, as proved by Euclid, we prove this formula. For example, substituting x equal to zero, I think you get the Möbius between zero and one. Okay. Which is minus n minus one factorial, which we proved directly on previous para. I am afraid that calculating this also by finite field method, we don't have time, so you do it yourself. Or we do it on next para. Okay, thank you.